made way too many plans again for this practice, so we just have to start. See if you can first start with letting go of your thoughts, emptying your mind. Maybe you feel your natural breath. Just arrive here onto your mat. Try to be in this present moment for the coming hour. Not being busy with anything else than yourself, your body, your yoga practice. Time you can start to deepen your breath. Just make every in and exhale a little longer, a little deeper. You can create a nice soft sound at the back of your throat. Activate your Ujjayi breath. To you, just take a moment to ask yourself why you are here on your mat. Maybe you like to set an intention for your practice, for your week, for anything that needs some attention. Gently start to open up your eyes. Maybe you like to cross your legs the other way around. Today I want to focus on the side body. Maybe you can just not go too deep into your poses, but really feel the lengthening, the strengthening of the sides into all these poses, because it needs some more attention. So see if you can start bringing one hand behind your back. You can interlace your fingers and then bring them to one side as much as you can. See if you can keep your shoulder blades down. And then you can let your head slowly move over to the elbow that is sticking to the side. Keep that other shoulder really low, away from your ear. Feel the stretch in the side of your neck first. Your spine long. Don't really push too hard, just see if you can slowly lengthen. Staying where you are for one more deep breath. And then release your hands. Bring one hand onto the floor. Bring the other arm from behind your back all the way over your head to the side. If you like to, you just make some circles with your hand on top, maybe in both directions. Feel that you can let your shoulder blade melt down over the back of your ribs. You feel both sitting bones rooted into the earth. Lengthen all the way from your hip to your fingertips, not collapsing into the other side. Neck is soft, one more deep inhale. And then slowly come back up. Maybe one side feels way longer now. You have way more space. And then bring your other hand behind your back. Interlace your fingers. See if you can sit up straight. Don't round or arch your back. And then let your head move in the opposite direction. Maybe you press your hands a little bit into your waist. Just feel that you find as much space as you can to the side of your neck, to your shoulder. One more breath here. And then slowly bring that other hand on the floor. Circle your other arm all the way up and over. And slowly lift up and over to the side. Try not to go as deep as you can. Keep lengthening through that other hand. Maybe you make some circles there. You can also turn your hand up and down. Feel the movement into your shoulder as well. The lengthening at the whole left side. Just for one more deep in and exhale. And then you come all the way back up. And then gently bring your right hand over your left knee, left hand behind you. Keep your sitting bones both rooted down, spine long. Easy twist. One more in and exhalation. And then slowly go to the other side. And then gently come back to the center. Extend your arms all the way up. Interlace your fingers. Just stretch yourself out for a moment. And then you bring your hands in front of you. Slowly slide all the way forward, rolling over your knees. And then make your way onto hands and knees. Maybe you'd like to make some circles first. See if you can just move every single vertebrae in your spine. Feel if there is any stiffness. If you can let go of some stress, some tension. Center. Maybe you like to widen your knees a little bit, coming into Anahatasana. Let your heart melt down in the direction of the floor. Sitting bones up to the ceiling. Maybe your forehead is down. Maybe you can bring your chin onto the floor. Just make sure that you're not pulling your own shoulders into your ears. Then you can lift your navel in and up, your heart comes back up, and walk your hands back under your shoulders. Now just come all the way onto your knees. See if you can slowly bring your right leg all the way to the side. Keep your hips on top of your left knee, right toes are facing forward, right hand onto your right leg, extend your left arm up and over. Already push that left knee into the floor. See if you can lift the whole left side of your rib cage away from that left hip. And then gently go all the way to the other side. Left hand under your shoulder, right arm over your head. Maybe you look underneath your own arm up to the ceiling. Push your right foot still into the mat. Staying here for one more breath. And then slowly come all the way back up. We change sides, knee back on the floor, other leg goes to the side. Make sure it's next to you. Find your balance on top of your right knee. And first bring your left hand down, lengthen your right arm up and over. You don't need to go too deep, you just want to feel a nice stretch and opening, softening of your muscles. And come back up. Gently moving over to the other side. You can always bring your hand onto a block if it's too far to the floor. Just push your left foot down, lengthen your left arm in the opposite direction. Maybe you feel some space in between all the left ribs. And then come all the way back up, knee back down to the floor. And then you come back onto hands and knees. Tuck your toes under. Sitting bones all the way to the back and up into your first down dog. Then just walk your dog here. Bend one knee, then the other. When you're ready, you come to stillness in downward dog. Make sure you soften your knees a little bit if you need to. Keep your arms in a long line all the way from your wrists to your shoulders. And then you lengthen all the way up to your sitting bones from there. Spread your fingers wide. One more breath here. And then you really slowly walk your feet to the front of your mat. Little steps. When you're forward, maybe you just grab your own elbows in front of your legs, maybe behind your legs. See if you can soften your back, soften your knees, bowing all the way forward from your hips. Staying here for one more deep in an exhalation. And then gently release your arms. Slowly roll up, vertebra by vertebra. Coming up into a standing position. When you're all the way back up, come to the top of your mat. Big toes together. Heels gently a little bit away from each other so you align the sides of your feet with the sides of your mat. Hands in front of your heart. And then on your next inhalation, lengthen up, lengthen through your side body, through your arms. And on your exhalation, slowly fold forward, hands next to your feet. Half lift on your inhalation, flat spine. And exhale, step your feet into high plank. Just hold your plank for a moment. If you like to, you bring your heels from side to side. Try not to hang into your back or into your shoulders. Just feel the movement, the mobility, and the strength. When you're ready, you come to the center. Bring your knees down, come all the way down onto your belly. And then see if you can slowly lift your heart up, look over your left shoulder, and gently come back. Lift your heart up, look over your right shoulder, and go back down. One more time each side. Lift up, maybe you see your feet, look over your left shoulder. And slowly go back. Last time, look over your right shoulder, lift your heart, and gently go back down. And then tuck your toes under, sitting bones to your heels, and rise back into down dog. A few breaths here. See if you can really lengthen through the sides. Push your hands away into the floor. Lift your sitting bones up a little bit higher into the sky. Drag your weight to the back and up. One more deep in an exhalation here. And then look in between your hands, soften your knees, and step your feet all the way forward. Half lift on your inhalation, long spine, then exhale, bow down. On your inhale, rise all the way back up. And bring your hands back in front of your heart center. Deep inhale, rise back up. And on your exhalation, bow down. Fingers aligned with your toes. Half lift on your inhalation. And exhale, step your feet back into high plank. Wait a little bit to the front. Maybe you bring your knees down and your chest and your chin. Or you come into low plank, chaturanga. From there forward into cobra. Or up dog, and come back into downward facing dog. Few in and exhales here. See if you can keep pulling your navel in a little, hug your ribs together. You can always squeeze your inner legs a little bit. Keep feeling the center of your body. One more deep in and exhale. Then look in between your hands, soften your knees, and step or float to the front of your mat. Half lift on your inhalation, and exhale, bow down. Your next inhale, rise up. And exhale, hands back in front of your heart. Last time, take a deep inhale, rise. And exhale, fold forward. Half lift on your inhalation. And slowly step, maybe a half back. Low plank, chaturanga. From here, come into cobra or up dog. And make your way back into downward dog. And then from here, see if you can bring both heels to one side. You can bring, you can bend one knee. So you lengthen the side body a little bit more. And then slowly move to the other side. Make sure you keep your arms in one line with your upper body. Don't bring your shoulders forward. And come back to the center. Now gently bring your right leg up. Keep your hips aligned for now. Pull your navel in. Maybe you spread the toes of your right foot. Stay here for one deep inhale. And exhale, drag your knee all the way to your nose, coiling in. When you inhale, rise back up. And bring your knee to your chest. Softly step your foot forward. Push your left heel to the back. Rise up into a high lunge. Taking a deep inhalation. And on your exhale, bring your left knee just above the mat. Slowly extend only your left leg out. And left knee just above the floor. Keep lengthening through your sides and your arms. Push your heel to the back. And left knee just above the floor. Lengthen that left leg one more time. And then bring your knee all the way down. Foot comes down. And then shift your weight back. And slowly let your weight melt forward. Deep inhale, rise back up. And exhale, lower down. Keep your hips next to each other. Don't overdo it. Two more. Pull all the way up. Keep the length through your front of your body to navel in. Last time, lift up. And slowly lower down. And then from here, you can gently bring your arms to the sides. Twist towards your right leg. You can bring your left hand to the outside of your right knee. Or you bring your right hand to the outside of your left thigh. Lengthening your left arm up and over. See if you can keep lengthening through that left side. Through the right side too, actually. Keep your shoulders down. Heart opens. And then circle your hands all the way down to the floor. Tuck your left toes under, lengthen your left leg. Hug your inner thighs together. And open your right arm up to the ceiling. See if you can lengthen your right arm over your head. Keep your hips aligned. Look underneath your right arm up to the ceiling. One more deep inhale. Then circle your right hand down. Step your right foot next to your left. Slowly make your way through your vinyasa from here. Back into down dog. Just listen to your body here for a moment. Notice how you're doing. Feel if you are warming up a little already. One more deep breath. And then lengthen your left leg up. Hold your hips aligned. Really try to engage your inner thighs. Lengthen through the ball of that left foot. One more deep inhale here. And then bring your knee to your nose, coiling. Deep inhale, extend your leg back and up. Then exhale, knee to your chest. Step all the way forward. Right heel presses back. Slowly lengthen your arms up. See if you can pull yourself away from that left thigh. Push your right heel back. Then bring your right knee just above the floor. And stretch your right leg out. Right knee just above the mat. And stretch your leg out. One more time, right knee just above the floor. Keep that left leg where it is. And then bring your right knee all the way down to the mat. Right foot comes down. And shift your weight back. Slowly bringing your hips forward in the direction of your left foot. And rise back up. Lower down with your hips. Keep your upper body long. And come back. Two more. Slowly going forward. Keep reaching through your fingers. And rise up. Last time, go all the way forward. And gently come up. And then you can go to the front. Bring your arms to the sides. Keep the strength though. Try not to hang into it. Just squeeze your inner legs together. Turn towards your left leg. Then bring your right hand to the outside of your left knee. Or your left hand to the outside of your right thigh. Right arm up. See if you can lift your heart. Open up the front of your ribs. Lengthen through both sides. One more in an exhale here. And then you circle your hands all the way down. Bring your right toes under, lengthen your right leg. Now have your thigh and your upper body together. Left arm rises up. Try not to hang into that hips. Keep them next to each other. See if you can maybe bring that left arm all the way over your head. Keep hugging knees together. One more deep in an exhalation. And then bring your left hand down, gently stepping your left foot next to your right. And make your way to your vinyasa. When you're back in downward dog, take a moment. Deep breath. Let go of any thoughts. Don't get distracted. One more deep in and exhale. And then look in between your hands. Soften your knees and step or float back to the front. Half lift on your inhalation. And exhale, bow down. Now bend your knees deep. Come all the way into chair pose. Just hold it here for a moment. See if you can shift your weight to the back. Maybe lift your toes off the floor. And then just lower your arms down and reach them a little to the back. And slowly lengthen them back up. Keep sitting deep, arms all the way down into the back. And gently lengthen back up. All the way to the back. And just go up one more time. On your next exhale, bow all the way down. Inhale, rise. Lift your heart and exhale, step or float back. Slowly go through the rest of your vinyasa. Back in down dog. When you're back into downward facing dog, see if you can widen your feet. A little bit wider than hip width apart. Walk your hands just a little, 10, 15 centimeters in. Bring your right hand to the outside of your left leg. It can be your calf, your inner knee, your ankle, your heel. Just pull yourself underneath that left arm. Keep your hips pushing to the back. Maybe you look up into the sky. Keep clawing the fingertips of your left hand into the mat so you're not going to slide away. And then bring your right hand down. Take a deep breath in the center. And then go to the other side. Left hand to your right leg. Pull your heart underneath your right arm. Press that right hand deep into the floor, sitting bones in the opposite direction. Maybe you look all the way up into the sky. Just for one more deep in and exhale. And then you bring your left hand back down, feet back, arms back, full down dog. And then from here, bring your right leg up. Right knee all the way to your left arm. See if you can touch it above your elbow. And slowly lengthen up. One more time. Left knee to your left elbow or above your elbow. And pull it up. And then bring your knee to your chest. And softly step forward. Now turn your left heel into the floor. Come up into first warrior. Maybe you pause up and down a little. See if you can deepen your pose. Keep your hips aligned with the front of your mat as much as you can. Push the outside of your left foot down into the earth. navel pulls in. Let's see if you can hook your thumbs around each other. Lengthen your arms up. And then take a deep inhale, lift your heart. And exhale, only round your upper back and your neck. Maybe you look to your navel. Deep inhale, lift up and over. And exhale, hug your chest in, chin to your chest. Two more, deep inhale, lift. And exhale, round. Last time, lift your heart. And exhale, hug your upper body. Then you come all the way to the center. Slowly bring your arms behind you. Stretch your arms away. And then from there, you bow forward into Humble Warrior. See if you can let your hips melt down. Open your right knee a little bit. Look to your own hips if they are facing the back of your mat. Give yourself a nice shoulder stretch. Keep reaching your arms up and over your head. One more deep in and exhalation. And then rise all the way back up, arms up to the ceiling. And then you bring your hands in front of your heart center. Slowly come all the way up onto your right foot. Lift your left knee. You can grab your knee, pull it a little bit closer. Root your standing foot into the floor. And then you can bring your right hand onto your hip. Grab your left ankle, place your foot at the inside of your thigh, and then squeeze everything to the center. Hands come in front of your heart, maybe your arms rise all the way up into tree pose. Now only if you like to, you bring your left hand on top of your left knee, and maybe you move over a little bit to the side. Try to keep looking in front of you. You don't need to go too deep. Just feel the balance. One more in and exhale. And then rise all the way up. It's fine if you fall out. Bring your hands all the way back in front of your heart center. And then from here, you bring your knee back to the front. Take a big step back with your left foot. And then bring your arms all the way up. Now slowly bring your hands in front of your heart center. See if you can twist towards your right leg. Bring your left elbow over your right thigh. Now really see if you can press your right hand into your left. Keep a nice wide upper back. Right shoulder is pushing up. Hug your inner legs together. Only if you like to, you spread out your arms. Maybe you reach your right arm all the way forward. It's kind of a difficult pose for many. So just see if you can find your own variation here. One more deep in an exhalation. And then gently rise all the way back up. And then slowly bring your hands down. Now from here, just turn around so you can see it a little better. Turn your toes, your upper body, everything to the side. Walk your right foot in front of your navel or your hips. Then extend your arm up and over. Push your hips up a little higher. And slowly release everything down. Deep inhale, push up and over. Really feel that you lengthen that side. And slowly lower. Two more. Deep inhale, lift up. Keep everything to the side. And slowly go back. Last time, lengthen up and over. And reach it all the way back. And bring your hands back onto the floor. Step back into a high plank. And then go through your vinyasa from here. Back into down dog. When you're back in downward dog, take a few in and exhalations. Just feel how you're doing. Extending through that side. One more in and exhale here. And then bring your left leg up. Your next exhalation, bring your left knee to your right upper arm. And rise back up. Left knee back to your right arm, cross it over. And lift back up. And then bring your knee to your chest. And with softness, step all the way forward. Right heel comes down, rise up into first warrior. Just take a moment here. Maybe you bounce up and down a little. Try to keep pushing your right hip forward, left hip back. One more in and exhale. And then hook your thumbs around each other. Lengthen through your arms, keep it long. And then lift your heart up. And round your upper back. Deep inhale, lift your heart up. And exhale, rounding your upper back, your neck. Two more. Deep inhale. Keep lengthening your arms and the sides. And round back. Last time, pull up. And slowly round. And then you release your arms, circle them behind you. Interlace your fingers, stretch your arms away. And then come all the way into a humble warrior. Keep one long line through the center. Not letting your hips pop to one side. Keep that left knee nice and bent. Push your back foot into the floor. One more in an exhalation. And then rise all the way back up. Arms up to the ceiling. And then bring your hands in front of your heart. Slowly come back onto your left foot. Maybe you have your knee for a moment. And then place your right foot at the inside of your left thigh for tree pose. Hands in front of your heart. Maybe they rise all the way up. Try not to look down. I sometimes just look down so I can see you. And then gently bring your right hand down on your right leg if you like. Keep squeezing in and up through the center line. Maybe you can move over a little bit to the right side. Maybe you wiggle that left finger. Sometimes it helps to keep the energy lifting you up. One more deep in an exhalation here. And then you rise up with control. Bring your hands back in front of your heart center. Right knee comes forward. And then take a big step back with your right foot. Now slowly lengthen your arms up. Keep the length in the sides. Bring your hands in front of your heart. Turn all the way towards your right leg, left leg, and bring your right arm over your left knee. Bring your left hand on top of your right. Really push your left shoulder on top of that right one. Keep pressing your right heel to the back. Don't lose the center line. Only if you like to, you extend your arms. Make sure you still breathe. Maybe you bring your left arm over your head. Keep pushing your right heel to the back. Stay here for one more deep in and exhalation. And then circle your left hand down. Lengthen both arms up. And slowly bring your hands to the floor. Step back into plank. And bring your left leg up, Bring your left foot all the way forward. I forgot one thing. Turn all the way towards the left side. So both feet are turning to the left. Lengthen your left arm up. And then from here, lift your hips up. Arm over your head. And slowly let your hips melt down. Deep inhale, pull up. Press that left foot away, hips up into the sky. And slowly lower. Two more. Lengthen and lift. And lower down. Last time, pull up. And slowly lower. Now you can circle your hands down, stepping back into your plank. And go to your own vinyasa from here. Back into down dog. And then take a few breaths. You can always take a moment into child's pose if you want. Make sure you keep always focusing on your own practice, your own yoga journey. Never be too ambitious. One more deep in and exhale. Then you look in between your hands, soften your knees, and step or float to the front of your mat. Uplift on your inhale. And exhale, lower down. Come back into Utkatasana. This time bring your hands in front of your heart center. Slowly twist to the left side. Bring your right elbow over your left knee. If you'd like to stay here, maybe widen your arms. Maybe you'd like to take a moment into your side crow. Do whatever feels good. When you're in your crow, take one more breath. And slowly come back to the center. Bring your arms all the way back up. And then from here, you bring your hands back. Turn to the other side. Left arm over your right leg. Take a nice twist. Find your own variation. Maybe you spread your arms. Maybe you come back into your crow. See if you can take one more breath. If you are all the way into crow pose. Coming back. And then lengthen your arms up one more time. Slowly sinking down, folding forward. Half lift. And exhale, step or float back. Gently go through your own back bend. Back into down dog. Then gently start to bring your right leg up. Now just open your right hip on top of your left for a moment. Bring your right heel in the direction of your left sitting bone. Keep lengthening your arms. Maybe you feel a big stretch at the whole right side especially. One more in an exhalation. And then lengthen your leg back up. Slowly pull your knee to your chest. And step your right foot forward. Left heel turns down, come up. Warrior two. And then from here, see if you can bring your left arm in front of you. Flex your hand like you're pushing something away. Other hand goes over your head, so you just lengthen. Push that left hand to the side, reach that right arm up and over. Keep the strength into your legs. One more deep inhale. And come all the way up. Same thing to the other side, right hand in front of you. Left arm over your head. Try not to sink over that right thigh. Keep everything just lengthening. Keep the action. One more deep in an exhalation. And come all the way back up. And then from here, bring your hands on your hips. Make your step a little bit smaller. And then lengthen the right arm forward. Reach all the way to the front as far as you can. Maybe you can grab your big toe with your middle finger, your index finger, and your thumb. Keep your hips aligned. Maybe you press your tailbone down for a moment. And when you're ready, you can extend the left arm up. Feel the stretch. Especially at that left side. Keep spinning your heart open. Make sure you keep your pose active. Try not to just hang into that right leg with your right hand. One more deep in an exhale here. And then slowly look down. Bring your left hand on your hip. Bend your right knee. Bring your right hand a little bit to the front. And then see if you can slowly come into Ardha Chandrasana. Keeping your weight a little bit forward into the toes of your right foot. And you can lengthen your left arm up. If you want to, you can bend that left knee. Get your left foot and press it away. Make sure you keep breathing. Try not to bring it up too much. It's not your dancer pose. One more deep in an exhalation. Then look down, lengthen your leg, and gently step back. Now from here, you swing your arms at the inside of your right leg. Gently go from side to side. Just a few times, lengthening your inner legs. Maybe you like to add your arms to whatever feels good. One more time, and then you come all the way to the left, right toes turn up, and gently sit down onto the floor. Nice. Now, if you like to, you can always sit onto a block. Bring your hands in front of your heart. See if you can lean a little bit to your left leg. So you can push the left arm into your left leg. Maybe you keep your left hand on your heart. Bring your right arm up. Or you bring your right arm behind your back. Bring the left arm around your leg. And maybe you can catch your fingers behind your back. Maybe you can even catch your right wrist with your left hand. Make sure you keep your back long. You keep your hips open. If it's possible, you lift your heart in your mind. And just stay where you are for one more breath. And slowly release your mind. Now bring your right hand to your right ankle. If this is too much, you can also bring your right leg down, or right knee down to the floor. And then see if you can slowly lift your left arm up. Lengthen over to the right side. Keep lengthening through your arm. Maybe you're able to catch your foot. Bring your heart underneath your arm. Lift your chest up. Just feel the length all the way from your left hip through your ribs, your armpit, your arm, all the way to your left hand. Try to keep spinning that heart open into the sky. Keep your right leg active too. You can always bend your knee. One more deep breath. And then rise all the way back up. Nice. Bring your hands in front of your heart or onto the floor. Maybe you can lift your sitting bones off the mat. And then float through to the front of your mat. Walk your right foot out to the side. Maybe you would like to bring your left knee down, or you keep it, your heel pushing away. Keep it nice and active. See if you can bring your elbows onto the floor. Maybe if you have the space into your hips, lengthen your arms all the way forward. Make sure you don't collapse. We just stay here for 3 more deep breaths. Just 2 more. Last one. Walk your hands all the way back under your shoulders. And then from here, you step your right foot next to your left. Slowly go through your vinyasa. And back in down dog. And then take a few in and exhalations before we go to the other side. Left leg rises up. Open your left hip on top of your right. Just press your hands away into the earth. Keep shifting your weight to the back. Drag your heel in the direction of your right sitting bone, but don't collapse into the right side of your body. One more deep in and exhale. And then lengthen your leg all the way up. Knee to your chest. And softly step forward. Root your right heel down, rise up. Back into warrior two. Take a moment to deepen your pose. And then you bring your right hand in front of you. Push your hand away. Lengthen that other arm over your head. Give yourself a nice stretch at the left side of your body. Push your right foot down. One more deep inhale. And come up. Slowly going to the other side. Push your left hand away in front of your belly. Lengthen your right arm over your head. Don't hang onto that left leg. Just lengthen your upper body. One more deep inhale. And then circle your hands down at the inside of your left leg. Slowly moving from side to side here. If you like to, you bring your heels up, your toes up, coming onto your heels. Just stretching a little bit different. And in your own time, you come all the way to your right foot. Let your sitting bones come down onto the floor or bring your block underneath. And then you start to push your right knee to the side. Lift your heart up. Maybe you can hug that arm a little bit closer to your leg. Keep your left toes pointing up, your knees pointing up. Maybe you bring your right hand onto your heart, left arm up. Or you bring your left arm behind your back, right arm around your right thigh, your right shin. And then see if you can catch your fingers maybe, or your left wrist with your right hand. Try to keep spinning your heart open. The moment you cannot breathe anymore, then just make it a little bit easier for yourself. Take one more in and exhale here. And then release your bind. Slowly bring your left hand to your right ankle. Maybe you'd like to bring your knee onto the floor. Just try to keep everything long and then you rise up and over, over that left thigh. See if you can maybe bring that left shoulder a little bit in front of your left leg. And then just see how far you can go. Try to keep spinning your heart open. Also, if you're just reaching your arm over your head, keep lifting that right shoulder. Lengthen through your fingertips. Staying here for one more deep breath. And then gently rise back up. Slowly with control, take your time. If your knee is down, bring your foot back onto the floor. Hands in front of your heart or in front of you onto the floor. And then pull yourself back up. Slowly moving to the front of your mat. Walk your left foot out. Hands under your shoulders. You can always release that right knee down to the floor. But if it's possible, push your heel to the back. Keep your hips aligned. And then maybe you bring your left elbow down and your right. Maybe you extend your arms all the way forward. Just stay here for four, three, two, and last breath. Hands back under your shoulders, and then from here, you step your left foot next to your right. Slowly go to your low plank or knees, chin, and chest down. Cobra or up dog, and back into downward facing dog. And then just slowly bring your knees down to the floor. Take the easy child's pose. Just take a moment. And maybe you can come onto your fingertips. Just lengthen your arms and your sides, even in child's pose. Slowly walk your hands back. See if you can come up a little bit, cross your ankles, sitting bones to the back. And then from here, you can widen your legs to the sides. If you like to, you can bring your hands behind you, in front of you, onto your hips. Just move a little bit to the front and to the back, finding the opening of your hips. Maybe you can hop your hips a little bit to the front so you can widen your legs a little bit more. Pretty different for everyone. Just see if you can keep your feet pointing up, knees pointing up. And then maybe you walk your hands forward a little. You can bring your elbows down. Maybe you can flatten all the way down over the floor. Let your chest melt. Try not to round your back. Keep pushing your sitting bones back into your mat. Don't turn your legs. Keep everything active. Just for one more deep in and exhalation. And then you walk your hands all the way back up. Slowly bring your hands to the outside of your knees. So You can gently bring your legs all the way together. And then maybe you hug your arms around your legs for a moment. Let your forehead melt down. You can round your shoulders, your upper back, hanging a little bit to the back to give it a nice stretch. And then you come all the way back up. Now see in the next pose if you really can stop whenever it's enough for you. Just see what works. So come onto your knees. And then let's start with bringing your right foot to the side. Your knees facing to the outside, toes to the other leg is just straight. Now from here, you can start to bend to the side. And maybe you can let your shoulder come down at the inside of your right leg. Now if it's possible, bring your right hand at the outside of your right foot. So your arm is going through that little bridge. Push your hand deep into the floor, and then feel that you can press your right knee away, your left shoulder up a little bit. If you like to, you catch the outside of your right foot with your left hand, and maybe you can shift your weight a little bit to the side and lengthen that right leg over your head into a preparation for Vishvamitrasana. Make sure you keep breathing, keep spinning your heart open. Keep pushing your right shoulder into your leg. One more deep in an exhalation here. And then gently bend your leg. Bring your foot back down on the floor. And release. Bring your knee back onto the mat. Maybe you take a moment into the center. Relax your shoulders. If you want to, after this practice, you can even try it with that other leg straight. So you make a full split like a side plank, but that's really difficult. So we just do this today. First coming back up, left leg to the side. Make sure it's pointing all the way to the side. Keep your hips nice and strong into the center. And then from here, you bring your left hand down, let your shoulder melt down. This can already be a nice stretch. You can even turn your right arm up. Just open that right shoulder on top of your left. Maybe you can bring your shoulder a little bit lower. Bring your left hand at the outside of your left foot. And then from here, you can see if you can catch your right foot, left foot at the outside with your right hand. Now really push yourself up. You can turn that left foot forward first. And then spin your heart underneath your arm. See if you can stretch out your leg. Keep pushing your right knee into the floor. See if you can stay here for two more deep in and exhalations. Last deep breath. And then you bend your leg, bring your foot back down, and come back to the center. Cross your ankles, sitting bones to the back, and come all the way onto your back. And then you can be happy you survived your practice, because we just slowed down from here. Knees to your chest. Make a few circles. And then bring your feet down. You can bring your right foot on top of your left knee. Maybe you push your knee away for a moment. And then bring your left leg towards you. Maybe you interlace your fingers over your shin or behind your thigh. If this is too easy, you can also bring your foot into your armpit, hug the other arm around, lengthen the other leg down to the floor. Always choose your own options. Keep listening to your body. Taking one more in and exhale here. And then you bring your left foot down. Let your right foot come onto the floor. Keep your legs exactly as they are. Maybe you push that right leg away a little bit. Bring your right arm to the side. Let your hips melt down to the floor. It's also fine, by the way, if you look up or not really a twist, it's more like a stretch into the outside of your right thigh, your hip. Maybe you feel it in your glutes, your lower back. Just stay here for one more breath. And gently come all the way back with your knees to your chest. Bring your spine into the middle. And then bring your right foot down, left foot on top of your right leg. And slowly bring your leg towards you when you're ready. Try to keep that left knee pushing a little bit away. Feel the opening of your hip. Your lower back down onto the floor. Make sure you're not going to lift your hips up. If you want to, you bring your foot back into your elbow, other arm around, and maybe you can lengthen that other leg down. Always make sure you don't feel any sharp pain into your knee. Stay here for one more deep breath. Left foot back on top of your right knee. And then just let both legs fall to the right side. So your left foot comes down. You can let your hips melt down to the floor. That is where you get the stretch. Let that left hip lower down to the floor too. Your left foot onto the mat. And then you just stay here for two more breaths. Take one more deep in and exhale. And then slowly bring your knees back to your chest. One more hug. Now if you'd like to end your practice into a headstand, a shoulder stand, or anything you still like to do, just really go for it. I always like, if you are warmed up, to go on a little. And otherwise, you can come into Shavasana, relaxing everything. Maybe taking a few deep breaths out through your mouth. And try to stay into Shavasana at least for 2 minutes. Only when you are ready for it. You just give yourself a nice stretch from there. You can make your way back up into a seated position slowly. See if you can stay there with your eyes closed for a moment to feel how you are doing, what your practice did for you. Maybe coming back to the intention you set at the beginning. And then you can bring your hands in front of your heart. Taking a deep inhale, and on your exhale, bow your head to your heart. Thank yourself for your practice today. And then you slowly come all the way back up. Namaste. Thank you guys. Have a beautiful evening. Any questions, please let me know. Otherwise, hope to see you back soon.